Army, led by Malcolm, Seward, and McDuff, are coming.
We will meet at Burnwood.
Donald Bain is not coming. Seward's son is there in addition to thousands of other soldiers. What is Macbeth doing?
He's guarding the great castle at Dunsane.
Macbeth is feeling guilty for commanding murder. He seems like he is too small to be a king. He is a baby wearing a giant's robe.
I can see why he's acting crazy because all the bad things he has done.
Let's keep walking and meet Malcolm, a true king.
We will do whatever is necessary to make Malcolm king and kill Macbeth.
Scene 3. I do not want any more reports. I will be fine as long as Burnwood does not uproot itself and move towards my castle. Malcolm was born of a woman, and the witches said, Macbeth, no one born of a woman can defeat you. Servant, why do you look scared?
Because there are 10,000...
There are 10,000 geese?
No, sir. They are soldiers.
Why are you scared? There are no soldiers.
But they are soldiers from the English army, sir.
Just leave right now. This is war. This war will either make me king forever or take away my throne. I have lived a very long life, and it is deteriorating. Is it Seaton? Seaton?
Seaton.
Do you need something?
Do you have any new news?
Everything you have heard is true.
Go get my shield. I'm ready to fight, too, until I am killed.
You do not need it right now.
I will wear it anyway. Send out more soldiers and kill anyone that is spreading fear. How is my wife doing, doctor?
She does not have a physical illness. She keeps envisioning bad things.
Don't you have any medicine to cure the mind?
I cannot fix the mind. She must do it on her own.
Bring me my armor. Please send out more soldiers too. Hurry. Doctor, can you heal my country? If you can, I'll be so glad. What medicine will stop the English army from coming into my country? Bring my armor and shield and come with me. I will not be afraid until that forest uproots itself.
I wish I was a long ways away from this place. I would never come back.
Scene 4. I hope people take cover.
I do not think they will.
What is this forest called?
Burnham Wood.
Break off every branch so they can hide behind it. Macbeth, Spears will not know what is happening.
We can do that.
We have no news except that Macbeth is still at his castle.
He wants us to make the first move. No one will fight Macbeth except the ones who are forced to.
But let's not get ahead of ourselves. Let's fight hard. Move our armies forward.
Scene 5. Hang our flags. We are strong enough to hold off. They can die of hunger.
Is it a woman crying?
I have almost forgot to know what fear is like. Horrible things are too common and cannot scare me. What was that cry?
Your wife. She's dead.
She was going to die. Every day she was getting close to death. Life is nothing more than an illusion. It is like an actor who worries for his part but is never heard of again. Life is told by an idiot, full of noise and emotion but lacking meaning. You have to tell me something. What is it?
Yes, I do. I just do not know how to say it.
Tell me.
I saw the forest move while standing on the hill.
Liar and slave.
You can kill me if it's not true, though you will see it coming.
If you are lying, I'll hang you. If what you say is true, you can do the same to me. I'm starting to doubt the witches. Prepare for battle. I'm getting tired of living. Bring the arms. At least we will die with armor on.
We're close enough now. Throw down these branches and show them who you really are. Uncle Seward, you and your son will lead the first battle. Brave Macduff and I will do the rest, according to our battle plan.
Good luck. If we meet Macbeth's army tonight, let us lose if we cannot fight.
Blow the trumpets. They loudly announce the news of death.
They have me tied to a stake. I can't run away. I have to stand and fight like a bear. Where is the man who was not born from a woman? He is the only one that I am afraid of.
What is your name?
You'll be afraid to hear it.
No, I won't. Even if you were one of the worst demons in hell.
My name's Macbeth.
The devil himself couldn't say a name I hate more.
No, and the devil's name couldn't be more frightening.
You lie, you disgusting tyrant. I'll prove with my sword that I'm not scared of you.
You were born from a woman. Swords do not frighten me. I laugh at any weapon used by a man who was born from a woman.
The noise is coming from over there. Show your face. If someone other than me kills you, the ghost of my wife and children will haunt me forever. I'll either fight you, Macbeth, or else I'll put down my sword unused. By the great noise, it sounds like one of the highest ranking men is being announced. I hope I find him. I ask for nothing more than that.
Come this way, my lord. The castle has been surrendered without fight. Macbeth's soldiers are fighting on both sides. Our noble men are battling bravely. The victory is almost yours, and it seems like there's not much left to do.
Our enemies fight as if they are trying not to hurt us.
Sir, enter the castle.
Why should I commit suicide like one of the ancient Romans? As long as I see enemies of mine alive, I would rather see my sword wound them than me.
Turn around, you dog from hell. Turn around.
You are the only man I have avoided, but go away now. I'm already guilty of killing your family.
I have nothing to say to you. My sword will talk for me. You are too evil for words.
You're wasting your time trying to wound me. Go fight someone who can be harmed. I lead a charmed life, which can't be ended by anyone born from a woman.
You can forget about your charm. The evil spirit you serve can tell you that I was not born. They cut me out of my mother's womb before she could bear me naturally.
Curse you for telling me this. You scared away my courage. I don't believe those evil creatures anymore. They tricked me with their word games, raising my hopes and then destroying them. I will not fight you.
Then surrender, you coward, and we'll put you in a circus, just like they do with the rarest and most deformed animals. We'll put a picture of you on a sign right above the words, "Come see the tiger."
I'm not going to surrender and have to kiss the ground in front of Malcolm or be taunted by the common people. I'm fighting a man not born from a woman. I'll fight to the end. I'll put up my shield and battle you. Come on, let's go out and make the...
I wish all of our friends could have survived this battle.
In every battle, some people will always be killed. But judging from the men I see around us, our great victory did not cost as much.
Macduff is missing, and so is your noble son. My lord, your son has paid the soldier's price, death. He only lived long enough to become a man, and as soon as he proved that he was a man by fighting like one, he died.
So he's dead?
Yes, he has been carried off the field. Your grief should not equal his worth, because then if your sorrow will never end.
Were his wound on his front side?
Yes, on his front.
Well, then he's God's soldier now. If I had as many sons as I have hairs on my head, I couldn't hope that any of them would die more honorably than he did. And that's all there is to it.
He is worth more moaning than that, and I will mourn for him.
He is worth no more than that. They tell me he died well and settled his scores. With that, I hope God is with him. Here comes better news.
Hail, King! That's what you are now. Look, I have Macbeth's cursed head. We are free from his tyranny. I see that you have the kingdom's noblemen around you, and they're thinking the same thing as me. I want them to join me in this loud cheer. Hail, King of Scotland.
Hail King of Scotland.
It won't be long before I reward each of you with what you deserve. I name all your earls the first earls that Scotland has ever had. We have a lot to do in this new era. We must call home all of our exiled friends who fled from the grip of Macbeth's tyranny. And we must bring justice to all evil ministers of this dead butcher and this demon-like queen, who apparently committed suicide. This and whatever else we are called to do by God, we will do at the right time and in the right place. So I thank you all, and I invite each and every one of you to come watch me be crowned king of Scotland at Scone.
Thank you.
All right, I'm going to go turn this off.